I was looking at the comment section of the last video, and many of you guys were asking for me to do this video, how to speed ramp like a pro in Final Cut Pro. I got a clip on the timeline right here, and we're gonna start with the range tool. This is the fastest way to speed ramp. Just press the R key to activate the range tool, then click and drag over the part of your clip where you want the ramp to happen. When you're in the retime dropdown, you will see options like normal, slow, fast, custom, automatic speed. And automatic speed is just when Final Cut Pro reads your clip's frame rate and selects the smoothest speed possible. Once you selected that, go up to the retime drop down and choose speed ramp to 0% or speed ramp from 0%. We're gonna use from 0%. That means it's gonna start from a static shot. It's gonna hold the shot and then it's gonna gradually increases speed. So you see these handles right here, this gray bar right here, just drag the handles to adjust the duration and intensity of the ramp. This is the result right here, and it looks, you know, decent. But of course, this is you don't have a lot of control when you use this automatic speed ramping right here. So when do you use this? It's great for fast edits like B-rolls or beginner-friendly effects. So if you don't have time or you just want something quick, then this is the way to go. I'm not recommending to use this. If you want to do something nice, then really make the time to do it. This next one is if you want more control or more precision, and you can custom everything depending on what you want. So play through your clip. Wherever you want the speed to change, just press Shift+B. Do it again where you want the effect to end and set a custom speed from the drop down right here. For example, if you click down this arrow right here, you can choose custom speed. You can choose 300%, 100%, 50%. 100% will be times 1. 300% will be times 3, 50% will be, of course, dividing the speed into 2, so it's gonna go slower. And then you can still use the small retime handles right here to make the transitions quicker or slower. This footage was shot with the FX6 at 60 frames per second. I slowed it down to 40%, and now I can do the speed ramping, speed it up really quick here, and then going back to the normal speed. The only thing with Final Cut Pro is that anything about animation you do in Final Cut Pro, you don't actually have the curves to just really fine-tune those ramping, those speed ramp. At least they introduced Smooth Slow-Mo recently, I think in the last update, maybe Final Cut Pro 11, and Smooth Slow-Mo with Optical Flow will make your footage even smoother when you slow it down. Final Cut Pro will create the missing frames, will guess the kind of frames that will come after the frame that you slow down, and then that will make it even smoother. Let's select this clip again, and then we're gonna go to the retime drop down. We're gonna go to video quality, machine learning, but also we're gonna use the smooth slow-mo option here. So we can, this is just, the difference is this is the AI version. Instead of just slowing down, this is the smooth slow-mo will actually use everything AI in Final Cut Pro. So let's see what it does. You can see on the top here, it will render, Final Cut will process and smooth things out. The only thing is I notice that whenever I use the smooth slow-mo option or the feature, when I look at it in the viewer, it's always very jittery and it's like lagging and having these echoes of frames right here. Once you render it, and sometimes even you have to export it to see, it's actually pretty smooth. So when do you use this? You can use this when you're slowing down your footage below the clean speed. For example, if 60 frames per second, I said earlier, it's gonna be 40%. Usually that's the clean speed. You can even go under that if you use optical flow and the machine learning and the smooth slow-mo feature. But here's the thing, to make these transitions or these effects work well, you're gonna have to add some music, some sound effects that will go well with it. I use different platforms for my music and for my sound effects, but right now audio is really cool because I can copy any sound or any music or any sound effects from another movie or from another video. I can just copy paste here with their LinkMatch AI, and I will get the same kind of vibe right away. It will suggest a couple of songs with the same kind of vibe. I'll leave a link in the description if you're interested in that again. But if this helped you, smash that like button, subscribe for more Final Cut Pro tips. That's it. See you in the next one. hopefully. Peace.